Hi, in this video I'm going to show you one of our developed application. We have not completed developing it, we are still developing the application. Let me show you the functionalities that we have developed, and I will let you know that what are the other functionalities that we are going to add in this application later. So let's see. So this is the application right over here. This is PandoCart. As you can see, I am opening it. And this is the home page of this application. At first, a user have to log in to get the full facility of this application, or he have to sign up. But right now, I am already logged into this application, as you can see. So I am not logging in. I'm going forward to the next step. So here, a user can select a departure city. He have to select a departure city over here, and he have to select where he want to go to. He will have to provide a keyword, and he will get a list of results as autocomplete feature has been implemented in this. So after the, selecting this departure city and going to city, we have to select the travel date, and we have to select the time we want to leave, and then we have to select the number of seats we want to book, and we have to click on find a ride. And after clicking on find a ride, this application will find the rides that are available for me on that date and the mentioned time. We can also find a ride by area group. We can type our area group name and we can find a ride from there. We can also find a ride by activity group. We can provide the activity group name and we can search for the ride. Also, we can offer a ride. So let's see what happens when we offer a ride. So from here we have to provide the address that we are leaving from here, and we have to click on continue. And after clicking on continue, we have to provide the address till where we are going. So we have to provide the last stop, and we have to click on continue. I am selecting this location over here and I am clicking on continue. After this, it will ask that if I want to want more passengers, and I can add stopovers. I can add stopovers over here, or and I can click on continue, or I can click on skip. If I click on skip, then this process will be skipped and I will be guided to the next step. Here it will ask that when you are traveling, I'll have to select a date that I am traveling, and then I have to click on continue. And as you can see that I have clicked on continue, and I have to select the time that I want to pick the passengers up, and I have to select the deviation, picking up or drop off deviation from route. I can select no deviation, I can select a plus or minus 5 minute or plus or minus 15 minute, and I can click on continue. Suppose I am selecting plus or minus 15 minute, and I'm clicking on continue. In the next page, I have to declare that how many passengers I can take with me, and here I can select amount that the amount of passengers I am able to take with me in my car. So supposedly I am selecting 3, and I am clicking on continue. Here is another option to what size of luggage can I take? I mean, can I take in my car? So I can select that also, and I can either add this or I can either skip this process. This is here, right? This is the next step over here, and this step will show the fares that we want to add in this trip. If we want to go with this fare that has been automatically calculated as per Google Maps, if we want to go within this fare, then we can confirm, or else we can decrease it or increase it. After this, we can add this ride to the area group or activity group if I want to, or else I can skip. And in the next page, it will show the confirmation. I can edit the details that I have provided, or else I can click on publish. Once I click on publish, the ride will be published, and the riders, those who want to join me in my ride, they can book the seats. There is another option in the application that is showing the profile option over here. So as you can see here, I am able to see my profile image, my profile name, and also I can see whether my place of identity is verified or not. I can see that my phone is verified and email is verified. For those users who are not verified, they will get an option over here like verify now, and they have to provide their phone number and they have to verify their phone number. And they can add their vehicles, and this vehicles list will be shown like here, and they can edit their profile from this edit option. Let's move on to other features. Here I can see the bookings that I have made. As you can see that these are the upcoming bookings. This is a tab that will show the upcoming bookings for me. There is another tab. This is the past booking. This will show the bookings that I have made earlier. As you can see, these are the bookings I have made. Also, there is another option for request to book. I can request to book a ride. There is an wallet option also. This wallet option will allow a user to transfer funds. Let's see what happens when I click on it. So as you can see that this is the total balance of my account, and I can withdraw this balance, and I can check from where I have got this balance. There are some preferences for the driver also. A driver can manage his vehicles from here. As you can see that these are the cards that has been added by the driver. He can update the card from here, from this edit option, or he can delete the card, and he can also add a new card. So let's see what options do we have in a new add card option. So when I am adding a new card, this is the card name, the card make, card model, card color, card registration number, and card images. And after that, after providing all these details, I have to click on submit. There is an all ride option also. This all ride option will show, this is under driver preferences. This all ride option will show all the rides that are offered by the driver. That means the when I'm offering a ride, it'll show that this is the ride that we have offered. So as you can see that there is an option for calling the passengers who have booked the ride. We can call these passengers also. And there is another option for logging out. This logout option will log out the user from the application. And I haven't mentioned that this SOS alert and contact us options over here, as the application is still under development, so we have not implemented this yet. But we are going to implement that. This SOS alert will be for the passengers if they somehow feel unsafe when they are taking the ride. So they can click on this SOS option over here, and it will automatically provide a SOS to our end. And here are other options for transfer funds. This transfer funds have still not implemented. It will allow the user to transfer funds to any other user. And there are the payments method. We have not implemented the payment method yet. So we are going to do that. And once we have done completing all this, this application will be live. Thanks for watching.